Raised by wolves with canine DNA in his blood, having trained more than 24,000 vets, helping you and your fur babies thrive. Live in studio, it's Pet Talk Today with Will Bangura, answering your pet behavior and training questions. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your host and favorite pet behavior expert, Will Bangura.
Good Saturday morning. It's October 30th. Thanks for tuning in and letting us be part of your Saturday morning. I'm Will Bangura, and you're listening to Pet Talk Today here on 1100 KFNX, where we talk about your pet's training, behavior, and health needs, as well as taking your calls and answering your questions about your pet each and every Saturday morning from 9 to 10 a.m. Today, we've got a very special program. In just a little bit, we'll be interviewing world-renowned, board-certified veterinary surgeon, author, educator, and entrepreneur, Dr. Teresa Fossum, right here live in studio. She's developed a CBD product for pets and also a product for senior dogs that are having cognitive decline. Now, I've talked a lot about CBD on the show in the past. And like I've said, as far as CBD products, there's a lot of them out there that are all bark and no bite. What's important to know is not every CBD product is the same. And so we're excited today because we're going to talk to somebody that really knows her stuff, really understands pets and understands the CBD and how that might benefit your pet. If you've got a pet that has pain issues, if you've got a pet that has inflammation issues, if you've got a pet has anxiety, we're going to talk about that. I'm still a little bit of a skeptic as to whether it helps with anxiety. I want to believe. I'm looking for that CBD product that definitely works. But we're going to be talking to her in just a little bit, and we'll be talking about that and the science behind that. But first, hey, good morning.
Good morning.
Beside me is my co-host and canine guru, Jordan Marsteller. How are you today?
Hello. I'm feeling pretty good. You know, yesterday was a little rough, but I got to do it every week. I'm sorry, guys. Okay. I know you're getting sick of me. But today I'm feeling pretty great, actually. I woke up, feel like I had a nice nap over the – yes, I said nap, not a nice sleep. I don't really sleep much, but – I'm feeling good this morning.
Maybe there's a CBD product that can help you sleep.
Maybe.
Hey, I got a question for you. Do you have pet health insurance for your pets?
You know, actually, I've just started looking into health insurance for my pets.
Well, you're going to like what I'm about to say, because anyone who's ever, you know, taken a sick or injured pet to the vet knows how expensive veterinary care can be.
Absolutely.
And it's in those sorts of situations where having a financial safety net to fall back on can be very, very helpful. It's also in those situations where you shouldn't have to decide between the health of your pet and the family's financial well-being. Anyway, this week, U.S. News and World Report published an article on pet insurance, and according to their research, these are the best pet health insurance plans. Now, I'm not going to go through the whole article. So if you want to get more detailed information, look for the article that was published this week by U.S. News and World Report on pet insurance companies. Anyway, they said the number one best pet insurance company by their rating was Healthy Paws.
Mm.
You might want to check them out.
Okay.
Number two was Trupanion. Number three was Pets Best. Number four, Embrace Pet Insurance. Number five, the ASPCA Pet Health Insurance. Number six, Pet First Pet Insurance. Number seven, FIGO. That's F-I-G-O, not Fido. And number eight, Pet Plan. And number nine, Nationwide. I don't know why they didn't do the top 10. They did top nine.
That is a very intriguing number.
It's actually odd. Okay. Yeah, I know. My sense of humor is very dry. But anyway, they also went on to talk about cost. And as far as these pet health insurance policies, they range anywhere from about $19 a month all the way up to $60 a month and plus.
That's actually...
Looks like the most expensive one at $63.61 for an average monthly fee is Trupanion. And it looks like the cheapest one at $18.80 a month is Pets Best. That's best. So
okay,
if you're looking, you know, I'm looking too. I've never had it before.
You know, what's really intriguing, apparently a lot of these insurance companies will also pay for behavioral training if your dog has severe anxiety and aggression. Now, again, I'm not like saying, oh, every one of these are because, but a lot of my clients are like, yeah, my insurance said that they'll pay for it. They just need the veterinarian to write a recommendation, apparently.
Oh, yeah. Okay. That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. Well, listen, we've got to, we're going to go ahead and take a quick break here to hear from our sponsors so we can keep the lights on, pay the bills. But when we come back, don't go anywhere. Stay tuned because we've got veterinarian Dr. Teresa Fossum here in studio and we're going to be talking about CBD products and your pet. Is there anything to be said about it? Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back after these messages.
Met my wife, you ain't never seen her before. Say you ain't been hanging around my crib. Well, here's something I want to know. I want to know what in the world is going down. How come my dog don't bark when you come around?
Uh-oh. That's a problem.
That is a big problem. Anyway, welcome back. I'm Will Bangura. Thanks for staying with us. If you're just joining me, you're listening to Pet Talk today here on 1100 KFNX, where we talk about your pet's training, behavior, and health needs, as well as taking your calls and answering your questions about your pet each and every Saturday morning from 9 to 10 a.m. We've got a very special guest that we're going to be interviewing. We've got Dr. Teresa Fossum right here in studio, and she's developed a CBD product for pets, also a product for senior dogs that are having cognitive decline. Dr. Fossum is a world-renowned board-certified veterinary surgeon, author of the best-selling textbook, Small Animal Surgery. By the way, that's in its fifth edition. She literally wrote the book on surgery for companion animals. She's also a serial entrepreneur. Her textbook has been translated into over a dozen languages. Dr. Fossum's background includes over 30 years of educating veterinarians and pet owners regarding diseases of companion animals. She's given over 1,000 invited lectures to veterinarians throughout the world and is often asked to be the keynote speaker at these events. She has been honored with numerous awards, including Distinguished Alumni and Continuing Educator of the Year. Dr. Fossum is also the CEO and founder of Epic Veterinary Specialist, which is building unique specialty veterinary hospitals in Arizona. She also currently serves as the CEO and co-founder of Dr. Fossum's Pet Care, which is developing safe and reliable wellness products for companion animals. She has served as the principal investigator for over $30 million in research funding from industry and the federal government. In 2018, she was the special assistant to the Secretary of Energy, developing STEM initiatives for the Department of Energy. She is also the founder and former director and executive director of the Texas A&M Institute for Preclinical Studies, or TIPS, a $60 million venture at Texas A&M University, which promotes public and private partnerships to speed the development of medical devices and drugs. Dr. Fossum served as a board of directors for the Viticus Group, formerly WVC, from 2016 to 2021, and as a board of trustee for the American Veterinary Medical Association. In this role, she was responsible for leading the development of association health and retirement plans, as well as other products for veterinarians. In addition to her textbook, which is considered to be the Bible of veterinary surgery, Dr. Fossum has over 100 publications, 5 books, and numerous book chapters to her credit. Wow.
That is phenomenal.
Welcome to Pet Talk today. Hey, thank you, Dr. Fossum. It's a pleasure to have you here.
I feel like I should have put on a different shirt.
Yeah.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you for having me.
Very good. So you've developed some products, and one of them is a CBD product. How did you first get involved? What led you to, with everything you've done here, after just reading that, what brought you to CBD? How did everything go to pot?
Great question.
Yeah, that's a good question.
So I started looking at CBD a couple years ago because I have an older Labrador, and he was born with a condition called albo dysplasia. So we knew he would have osteoarthritis as he got older. Right. And he's a swimmer. He likes to dive in the summers, and he gets lame. And so I thought, you know, I don't want to keep him on non-steroidals. He didn't do well on those. Like many dogs, they have GI issues. So okay. I started looking at what else is out there. And when I started looking at CBD, I didn't like what I saw in the market, but I liked the research that was out there that was more basic science. And so I thought, well, I want to make sure I have a really top-notch product to give my dog. Let's just make one ourselves. So wow. That got me started.
Yeah, fantastic. So talk to us. You mentioned a couple things about, different products out there. What are some of the things that pet owners need to know about CBD and look out for?
So there are two big things. First off, no one should ever purchase a product that doesn't have a certificate of analysis that they can review. And they're simple. They look complicated, but the fact of the matter is what they tell you is what cannabinoids are in there, what terpenes are in there, and then they go on to tell you. So the issue when you grow cannabis is that it's a soil remediator. It pulls everything out of the soil. In fact, they planted cannabis around Chernobyl to remove radiation from the soil. So if you grow it somewhere where there's been pesticides or herbicides or heavy metals, it's going to concentrate in the flower, and that's what you're going to be giving your pet. So you want to make sure that that's been checked for. There are no mycotoxins, fungal elements in it, no bacteria. You want to make sure that there's no pesticides, herbicides, or heavy metals. So a certificate of analysis will tell you that. And it's really important because there's some bad products out there that can do harm.
Yeah. You know, last time I looked on Amazon, when I'm looking at all these CBD products, you know, all these chews that are out there, I've never seen a certificate of analysis.
Dump
so, and a matter of fact, ladies and gentlemen, this week, ABC News, they reported on CBD products, and they found that, quite frankly, most of the CBD products that they found had no CBD in it.
Huh.
And the other ones that they had, most of the rest of them, did not have the levels of CBD that they said they had on the label. So would that certificate of analysis would be a big thing. That would have resolved that. So, yeah, you've got to be really careful.
Well, keep in mind that CBD is not regulated.
Okay.
So it is we hear this all the time, but it's the Wild West out there. So that is an issue you just raised, is if you don't look at a certificate of analysis, you don't actually know what you're buying, and what you're paying for is the cannabinoids. Mm-hmm. So you want to make sure that there are plenty of cannabinoids in your product.
Now, some people that might not be familiar with it, they might be asking, so is my dog going to get stoned if I give him this?
Yeah, so the pet products, if it's hemp, it's less than 0.3% THC, period.
Okay. And what does that mean as far as, you know, amounts and pets?
So it's a very low level of THC. It's not gonna get your pet stoned. And CBD doesn't. It's not psychotropic, right?
Right.
So it's not gonna make your pet high.
Okay. Because a lot of people, you know, they want to, and we want to make sure they're not, the owners aren't taking the stuff either. You know? You just go to your own dispensary, folks. You can get it there. So tell us, what is CBD good for?
The main indications that people are using CBD for right now are problems with mobility, so osteoarthritis. People are using it for anxiety, and we can certainly talk about, you know, what the research is out there. I think probably the best known one is probably seizures, because that's the only FDA approved drug on the human side, is a drug called Epidiolex, which was licensed for use in children with seizures. So those are the main.
Do you, or does the veterinary field, and of course that might be a loaded question because FDA hasn't approved it. What about CBD and dogs with seizures?
So there are studies. There was a study actually out of Colorado where they gave dogs with seizures. So they kept them on standard care and added CBD. And what they found was that the reduction in seizures with CBD was directly correlated to the plasma level. So, and every dog absorbs CBD differently. So they gave 2.5 mgs per kg to those dogs, and they had about a 33% reduction in seizures. But honestly, I think that probably a higher dose would have benefited more dogs.
Now, I read a study, and it might have been where they only used CBD with seizures. But I read a study where it reduced seizures by 89%.
Interesting.
I don't know if the study or the research was any good, but yeah. So I'm hearing good things about CBD and seizures. Do you have any direct experience with that, or?
I don't. Okay. I don't. Well, now we do have pets that use our product. Mm-hmm. That, in fact, I was talking to a lady just the other day who has a cat that has had seizures, started at the beginning of the year, and she was giving all kinds of medications. Idiopathic. So we don't know what the cause of the seizures was.
Mm-hmm.
So then all you can do is try and treat it. So she started CBD in March, our CBD, and her cat has been seizure free since July.
Okay. And what are some of the other things that the CBD is good for with pets?
So I think the main use people, so a lot of older dogs are getting CBD. People are just trying to make the quality of their life better mm-hmm. for whatever remaining time they have. So, and a lot of those are mobility issues. But I think some of it, you know, we all have an endocannabinoid system. And the thought is perhaps as you age, you don't make the normal amount of endocannabinoids anymore. And so when we provide cannabinoids like CBD, but there are lots of other ones out there too, then we're just supplementing the natural system that may be failing.
Got it. Okay. Now, what in terms of the CBD? Well, first of all, I was on your website and I read a bunch of reviews, and you've got phenomenal reviews. I mean, the people are raving about this product. They're talking about dogs that are 14 years of age that could barely move, and all of a sudden they're up and moving again. And contrary to my skepticism, there's a bunch of great reviews about people using your CBD product, and it's helping their dogs with anxiety. And I've been looking for CBD product that works. Now, I ordered your product. I should have ordered it before the show.
Right.
But I've been busy. I didn't think about it. I'll report back. And maybe we'll have you back on.
Okay.
I bought that because those listeners know that I've got a miniature schnauzer named Boo. And the reason Boo was named Boo, because Boo's a scaredy cat.
That's right.
Okay. And there are certain things, you know, Boo's gotten a lot better, but there are certain things that Boo is still scared of. So we're going to give it a shot. We're going to see how it works with Boo. But like I said, you've got some great reviews, which is fantastic. And I'm a huge promoter of CBD when it comes to pain, inflammation. I'm a huge promoter. I know everything that I've read tells me that it's an amazing, amazing, product that can help. I guess my question would be, how does that compare to some of the pharmaceutical stuff that's out there, and what might be the pros and cons between the CBD and the pharmaceuticals?
So there's not a head-to-head comparison, so I can't make that with any good evidence-based medicine.
Mm-hmm.
But I will tell you, I think CBD has far fewer side effects. So if it works in your dog for arthritis, I think you're going to be happier than if you're giving, you know, any of the more potent pharmaceuticals that we do know have serious side effects.
Absolutely. And you know, my thinking is, hey, if they're an older dog, you know, there might be organs that are in decline. You know, they've got other health issues. And the last thing we want is medication that's going to be causing all kinds of crazy side effects.
Sure.
Making their health even worse.
Kidneys, liver. Yeah, you have to watch.
How is CBD metabolized?
So it is metabolized in the liver, and so one of the things we do see, and we still don't really know what the significance is, so we do see an elevation in alkaline phosphatase, which is a liver enzyme. Now, there are other liver enzymes that we don't see an increase in. So the thought right now is this because we're activating enzymes in the liver that we see this elevation, or are we doing some harm?
Mm-hmm.
And we honestly, we don't know, because these are, for the most part, client owned dogs, and you'd really need to do biopsies of the liver to get a better idea what's going on from a pathology standpoint. Mm-hmm. That just doesn't happen. Nobody's going to do that. You know, I have been talking with a group called National Animal Supplement Council, and I wrote a safety study for them. So we're going to look at that, and we're still deciding what population we're going to use. But if it's experimental animals, then they will likely get liver biopsies. So we may be able to answer that question.
Okay. That'll be good. Now, is it different dogs and cats?
Very little research has been done in cats, but what we do know is they absorb it differently. And so what we recommend is a lower dose, a lower starting dose. So for dogs, we generally start at 2 mg/kg twice a day. In cats, we do 1 mg/kg, so half that dose.
You know, that brings me to a whole nother set of questions as it relates to other CBD products that are out there. You know, we already talked about there's typically not a certificate of analysis, and we know that ABC News just did their report, and most of the CBD stuff that's out there, I'll say it, snake oil.
Yeah, and even the products that are good coming from reputable companies, for the most part, are human companies that have slapped a pet label on their product.
Mm.
And my issue with that is they spent very little time, for the most part, figuring out how to dose it.
Yeah.
And so there are some of the products that get brought into me by my clients, and they want to know, you know, how much should I give? And I can't tell.
Sure. We need to take a quick break. We've got to go to news. I'm Will Bangura. You're listening to Pet Talk today here on 1100 KFNX. We've got Dr. Teresa Fossum in studio talking about her CBD products. We're going to talk more about that after the news. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Never tells me that he's sick of this house. He never says, why don't you get off that couch? He don't cost me nothing when he wants to go out. I want you to love me like my dog.
Welcome back, everybody. I'm Will Bangura. Hey, ladies, love your man like you love your dog. He'll always come home wagging his tail. You're listening to Pet Talk today here on 1100 KFNX, where we talk about your pet's training, behavior, and health needs, as well as taking your calls and answering your questions about your pet each and every Saturday morning from 9 to 10 a.m. Today, we've got Dr. Teresa Fossum right here live in studio. She's developed a CBD product for pets and also a product for senior dogs that are having cognitive decline. And so we're going to get right back into our discussion. Before we went to the news, we were talking, I think, about dosages. And different species and different size animals within the same species, they all can't take the same dose, can they?
They can't. And I think it's probably related to the number of receptors they have in their brain, because that's typically where we see issues. You know, there are cannabinoid receptors throughout the body, but the brain is the one that we see if we give too much.
Okay. So if I go to my dispensary and I ask my bud tender and I say, hey, I want to get some CBD oil for my pet, they're not going to ask me, is it a dog? Is it a cat? They're not going to ask me, how much does it weigh? I don't even know if they'll tell me how much of that stuff I should give. I was there one time, and I listened to him talk to somebody that had a great day, and they said, give him 30 drops a day. Well, who knows what that is?
Exactly.
You know, is that something that's going to harm them? Is it something that's going to help them? Well, Dr. Teresa Fossum of Fossum's Pet Care has done all the work for you. She's done all the research for you. She's figured out the magic recipe for the CBD. What is the best kind of CBD that actually works? You know, what is the correct dosage for your pet? And these things are things that a lot of pet owners, they don't think about. And like I was saying also before we went to break, most of the CBD products out there are I'm just going to be blunt, they're garbage.
Yeah.
ABC News just did a report on it, and most of what they found had no CBD in it. These are the stuff you're getting on Amazon, folks, on Chewies.com. I think Bezos is going to come after you because he needs more money.
He needs to fund that next trip.
Okay. But anyway, you know, in addition to that, ABC News said, hey, even the ones that we found CBD in, most of them didn't have the amounts that they were saying. And you were talking about a certificate of analysis. Now, your CBD is independently tested, is it not?
It is. We do third-party testing on all of our products.
So there's no bias when it comes to that. You don't pay them for that, do you?
Well, we pay them, but we don't pay for the results. We don't pay for them to test.
Right. And they're obviously a very reputable company. And if they were doing things, underhanded, you know, then they probably wouldn't be in business anymore. So talk about anxiety.
Okay.
And CBD.
So there's research out there on osteoarthritis now, peer-reviewed publications. When I say research, there's research on seizures. To my knowledge, there's really not much out there using it in, you know, client on dogs for anxiety. So what I can tell you is what we get back from our clients. A lot of them do use it for anxiety, and a lot of them report that their dogs are calmer on the product. Now, I should probably say, you know, CBD is not CBD, or everybody thinks of it as just CBD. There are 140 different cannabinoids out there. Most of them, we don't even know, you know, what the indication for them would be. But there are some. Like we added on our first tincture product, we added CBG to ours. So cannabigerol, which is really the mother of all cannabinoids. So most of the others come from some kind of metabolism of CBG. And it's also, but it's very expensive. A few years ago, it was like $40,000 a kilogram. The price is coming down, but very expensive. So it's considered the Rolls Royce. And we found evidence in the literature that if you combine CBD and CBG, then you get a synergistic effect. So 1 + 1 doesn't equal 2. In that case, 1 + 1 equals 3. So we added a fair amount in our first tincture, and we actually have a new one coming out that's got even more. It's going to be 45% CBD, 45% CBG. And then we added a third cannabinoid, which is CBN. And CBN is really the one that everybody wants to take for sleep, for, you know, restlessness. So we're hopeful that that will even improve this anti-anxiety effect.
That's interesting because, I guess my question then would be, and I don't know if you know, you know, all these, we got all these commercial products that are out there, you know, and a lot of them are chews. You know who they are. You've seen them. Do we know if they're just CBD? Do we know if they've got the CBG and the CBN in their products?
So I don't know of any other pet products that have CBG and CBN in it. There's a product out there that has CBDA, which is the acidic form of CBD. But I don't know of, and I'm sure there are some, but not the main players.
Now, you mentioned about the CBG, it's not cheap.
No.
Right? It's come down.
CBN is expensive as well.
Is it?
Yeah.
So when it comes to the products that we see on Amazon, the products that we see on some of the other big online stores that you can buy from, like Chewy's, or even when you get into some of these big box pet stores like Petco, PetSmart, it's probably safe to say, I'll say it so you don't have to, that there's not CBG and CBN in it. For one thing, it costs a lot of money. And, you know, they're trying to sell these products as cheap as they can.
Absolutely.
So they can push it. I mean, we've got
CBD. I can buy it for $10 a bottle, and yeah, that bottle's supposed to last me, you know, 4+ months.
Right. And so I'm wondering if when it comes to the anxiety stuff, because I told you right from the beginning, I was honest, I'm a skeptic when it comes to anxiety. I'm just wondering if that's the big difference.
It could be. It could be.
I know that with the medical cannabis, okay, that when you're looking at broad spectrum, it makes a big difference. And now your product is broad spectrum. What kind of differences are there with, you know, there's broad spectrum, full spectrum, and
isolates.
Isolates, okay.
Yep.
Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah. So full spectrum means it has all the cannabinoids, terpenes, and it has THC in it. If you remove the THC, which we've done in our product, we've taken it all out, then it's a broad spectrum product. And then if you, as they are manufacturing this, as they're, you know, going through the process of making CBD, you can actually get it down where it's 99.9% pure CBD. So that's an isolate. And that's what's been approved by the FDA for seizures in people. It's an isolate. My issue with just an isolate is, first off, everybody thinks the entourage effect is important. That means that having multiple cannabinoids and terpenes is really important to get the full effect. So the closer you can get to the whole plant, the better. But in our case, we're just worried about the THC, especially if you have a tasty product. Mm-hmm. Then if an animal got into a jar, mm-hmm. say of chews,
yeah.
and they ate the whole thing and, you know, they could potentially get THC toxicity. So we decided just take it out.
And there is such a thing as THC yeah. toxicity with pets. And as far as you were telling me, I think at one of the breaks, that there's a big difference between how humans and like dogs, they handle THC.
Yeah. So dogs have a lot more receptors in their cerebellum than people do. And so they're much more sensitive to THC.
So people need to really keep their stash locked up,
so then,
right?
Oh, what please. You're saying is those people that like to, quote, get their animals high, that is definitely
dangerous.
A no-go. That is dangerous.
It is dangerous, yeah. No, dogs don't need much THC. Now, just to be clear, I know oncologists, veterinary oncologists, who are treating dogs with, say, bone cancer, where it's exceedingly painful. And they will add THC, but they're very careful about the amount that they give.
Yeah. And that I think has one of the things that I think is so important is that I don't believe, because it costs money to do the research and find out what the amounts should be. And, you know, I think a lot of the reasons that these other products can get away without, you know, needing to know that stuff is because they put very little to nothing in their product.
Right.
You know, so it might be relatively maybe safe, but, you know, is it really going to...
Am I just paying for a beef-flavored chew?
Yeah, is it going to do the job?
Is it efficacious? That's the question. You know, safety and efficacy.
Absolutely.
There we go.
Now, what are some of the potential, if there are any, side effects that might come from CBD?
Sedation, probably the number one. If you, you know, potentially you could get dogs that... We've seen a few dogs that will vomit, especially on the tincture. But the tincture has oil in it, and I think it's the oil that's causing these dogs to get a upset stomach. Because when we were talking on break, is that CBD is used as an anti-emetic in people that get chemotherapeutics.
For getting rid of the nausea, if you don't know what that big word was.
So it stops the vomiting. So I seriously doubt it's the CBD that's causing the vomiting. I think it's the oil.
Yeah.
And so in those cases, you know, you can't, we see companies all the time advertising that they have a CBD treat. Well, that's not legal because CBD is not approved as a food additive and a treat is food. So we can make a chew, cause chews have been approved. I know, but they can't look, for example, you know, we've got, you know, a product that looks like a dog bone.
Yeah.
You can't do that with CBD.
Ah.
That would be against FDA.
Interesting. FDA.
Yeah. What about a heart?
Nope. Well,
because I see
maybe a heart. You
I
might
see
get away
these,
heart.
You know.
Yeah,
these,
I've seen those ones where it's like
heart
a heart.
Chews,
yeah.
You know, playing on the pet owner's emotion.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Trying to say, yeah, buy this one because it looks like a heart.
Ethos, you know? Ethos, or pathos.
I don't know.
I can't remember.
Now you've got another product. And that is for senior dogs that they're getting some mental decline. I want to talk about that. But first, we're going to have to go to break. We got to listen to our sponsors so we can pay the bills. I'm Will Bangura. You're listening to Pet Talk today here on 1100 KFNX, where we talk about your pet's training, behavior, and health needs, as well as taking your calls and answering your questions. Don't go anywhere. When we come back, we'll be talking more with Dr. Teresa Fossum about CogniCaps and your dog's cognitive decline, if they have them.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
Welcome back, everybody. I'm Will Bangura. Thanks for staying with us. If you are just joining us, you're listening to Pet Talk today here on 1100 KFNX, where we talk about your pet's training, behavior, and health needs, as well as taking your calls and answering your questions about your pet each and every Saturday morning from 9 to 10 a.m. Today, we've got Dr. Teresa Fossum right here live in studio. She's developed a CBD product for pets and also a product for senior dogs that are having cognitive decline. So let's get right back into the interview. Before we went to break, I started talking about, you've got a product for senior dogs that have cognitive decline. And I think it's called, is it CogniCaps?
CogniCaps, yep.
Talk about that.
Yeah. So, what we do at Dr. Fossum's is we really look for unmet medical needs that we can potentially, you know, fulfill with the natural product. And so I'm a surgeon. I try and stay in my lane, but I reached out to a friend of mine who's a veterinary neurologist and treats a lot of dogs with what we call CCD, canine cognitive dysfunction, which is essentially Alzheimer's disease.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, dogs, we've all seen those old dogs that forget where they're supposed to urinate or they'll stand in the corner and they can't really figure out how to get out. Well, that's cognitive decline. So, Dr. Curtis Dewey, who is in New York, put together a formula that his point was, if I could get every client that had a dog with CCD to take these 11 different, you know, compounds, their dogs would get better. But what client can afford to do that? You know, you can't source it and then get 11 different and be, you know, prohibitively expensive. So we did that. We sourced them. We put 11 different products in this capsule. And it's new. It's just come out. So we do have a clinical trial that is ongoing, but it's too early to give any results. But it's got Eastern and Western medicine in it. So it's got a lot of Chinese herbs in it that have been shown and been used for centuries for cognitive decline.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's got, you know, some more Western therapeutics, SAMI, you know, a few things like that. So it's really this mix. And we just, you know, we wanted something that would maybe not make these dogs, you know, 100% like they were when they were younger, but allow them to live their life without. It's so disturbing for people when their dogs have CCD, you know, because, you know, these dogs tend to sleep during the day. They vocalize at night, so they keep the people up. And that's actually one thing that we get reports from people on our CBD product is that these dogs tend to sleep through the night.
And that you think is the CBN that's in there?
Well, our last product, so the CBN is a new product we're coming out with, just had CBD and CBG. So it was one of those two.
Okay. Okay. Got it. Okay. In terms of the canine cognitive dysfunction, are there really any good pharmaceutical options?
Not much out there. There's some diets. Diet will help. Like, and we do know that things like MCT oil may benefit these dogs. But no, there's really not much out there right now.
So MC2 oil, would that be like coconut oil? Is that the medium chain?
Yeah, medium chain triglyceride oil.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh. So that helps them. Now, as far as if anybody wants to get and try your CBD product, they might have a pet that has painful conditions. They may have some inflammation. Maybe they've got some anxiety. How can they find you? How can they purchase your product?
So drfossums.com. That's drfossums.com. You can go on our website. Products are all there. You have any questions, call us. We love to talk to people. We do that all the time. I get a lot of emails from people who say, oh, my dog's on whatever drugs. Can I also add CBD to that? So when we get those emails, I actually answer them myself. So it's not a call center that's going to give you that information. It's me.
Well, that's amazing.
That's phenomenal.
In and of itself. People, you hear that? You get to talk to a world renowned, veterinarian about this. And as far as I know, from the medical field, veterinary field, you're the only one doing this.
I don't know if I'm the only one, but there aren't many.
Yeah.
I'll tell you that. And we mentioned this earlier, but, you know, be really careful of the human products. So our product is human grade. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we don't sell to humans, but I will tell you, I have a lot of people I know that are taking our equine product.
Yeah.
Because it's a high concentration.
Okay.
You know? But we try to be very careful. We try and play within, you know, the grounds that the FDA has laid out for products.
Well, now Jordan's going to be getting that equine CBD, because I know Jordan. He's going to want to try it, you know.
Hey.
Next thing you know.
Direct science right there.
Next
first hand.
Next week he's going to be coming in neighing. But, so the nice thing about one of the things that I love about your products, and hey, don't take my word for it. Don't take Dr. Fossum's word for it. You want to find out what's going on. Check out some of the fantastic reviews that she has. Get on her website. They've got video testimonials from people. This is something that's been a game changer for a lot of people that have had elderly dogs that have just been suffering with mobility issues, suffering with pain issues. That's got to be one of the wonderful things about the product that you make. That's got to make you feel good.
Makes me feel wonderful. I mean, that's our passion, is helping dogs. It's what I've done all my career. It's helping pets. And so we talk to these people, and I have people tell me that we had one lady the other day who said that her dog had bilateral cruciate ligament surgery and couldn't get up. And her husband wanted her to euthanize the dog, and she decided to try our CBD, and now he's mobile. And
wow. That's amazing.
He's going to live for a while. So, I mean, it's an old dog. But
life-saving.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
And, you know, I didn't even think about that. You know, we get our elderly dogs, and, you know, they're suffering with pain, and they can't move. And, you know, we start thinking about that very difficult question, you know.
Is it better to put them out of their misery?
Right.
Or not, right.
And, For a lot of pets, that I know, for a lot of dogs anyway, I mean, I deal more with dogs than any other animal, but boy, when they get older, that's what a lot of them are just riddled with.
Yeah.
And a lot of times that for a lot of people is the reason why, you know, they're having problems with that. Other than the mobility issues, the pain, the inflammation, what other, are there other things that CBD is good for with the pets?
So there's no research to back this up, but if you look in the literature, at least in the human field, they're using it for cancer.
Mm-hmm.
They use it for inflammatory bowel disease, especially CBG is good for that. You mentioned sleep, insomnia, CBN is a cannabinoid that's used for that. So there's going to be, we're going to see a lot more indications as we learn, as there's more research and we learn more.
Now, you had talked about, you know, the GI issue, and you talked about, did you say the CBG?
Mm-hmm.
And you said you've got a new product coming out that's going to contain that?
So our past tincture and our chews have CBD and CBG in it.
Okay.
Our new tincture is actually going to be a higher, much higher concentration of both, so it'll last longer. So we're not dosing any differently. We're just giving you more product. And so we wanted to make sure that no matter the size of the dog, it lasts at least 30 days. But in some of these little dogs, it'll last.
Yeah.
We have one that'll last for 463 days.
So wow. That's a long time.
So we're as the science is improving, we're trying to keep up with that and add the cannabinoids that make sense.
And, you know, one of the things, and I'm sure you've seen this, you know, dogs that are stressed, dogs that have anxiety, they've got a lot of GI issues, IBD and all kinds of things. Now, you know, it could be which came first, the chicken or the egg. But,
right.
You know, they do go, I've seen it with our clients, you know, hand in hand. How about you?
Yeah, absolutely.
So
stress is a cause.
So that's exciting about the fact that with that CBG and that you're even adding more. I think that, you know, the fact that I'm hearing such good things about your product and anxiety and now hearing about, you know, what CBG can do for GI stuff.
Yeah,
I
was
having
the same thought.
Being a real good combo there. And the other thing, anxiety and cortisol. I mean, what does cortisol do? Inflammation, right?
Yep.
So that in and of itself, you know, I'm starting to think about that. You know, even if it didn't have anti-anxiety effects, I might be recommending that.
It's treating the symptoms.
Yeah. Well, folks, we are just about out of time. Boy, things go quickly. So glad you could come in today, Dr. Fossum. It's been a pleasure. Give out your information one more time so people know how they can get your product.
Yep, absolutely. It's drfossums.com, drfossums.com. And just go to our website. And if you have questions, we've got numbers there. Just give us a call. Happy to answer them.
So if you've got a senior pet that is in cognitive decline, if you've got a senior pet that has problems with pain and inflammation, or you got a dog that has issues with anxiety, be sure to go to her website. Check out her product. It can be a big deal for your dog. We'll see you guys next week. We're out of here.